preparing for hell? Little Brianna's family went to church regularly and also had devotions at home every morning and evening. Then Brianna had a baby born again and surrendered her life to Christ. But her life didn't change overnight as she would have loved and expected. She was told she still had to work out her salvation with fear and trembling. She didn't automatically stop getting people angry. Her parents still complained that she made too much noise when she played. Her big brother still got on her nerves all the time, so they quarreled a lot and even fought physically sometimes. After she had heard so much about heaven and hell, she became afraid that she might not be able to fulfill all the conditions for making it to heaven. How could she ever get to a point where her life would become pleasing to God and she would be able to spend eternity with Him when she had all those temptations surrounding her and she kept failing? She heard a lot about heaven. It is a very beautiful place. People there are blessed with unimaginable joy and so on. She also heard much about hell. For instance, hell is a place of terrible darkness where people will cry and gnash their teeth. It is an eternally burning furnace. There are even worms in hell, worms that will never die but torture people ceaselessly. Hell is also a place of distressing thirst, and one terrible feature of this thirst is that it can never be quenched. Then Brianna heard the story of Lazarus and the rich man. Luke chapter 16, verses 19 to 24. There once was a rich man, expensively dressed in the latest fashions, wasting his days in conspicuous consumption. A poor man named Lazarus, covered with sores, had been dumped on his doorstep. All he lived for was to get a meal from scraps off the rich man's table. His best friends were the dogs who came and licked his sores. Then he died, this poor man, and was taken up by the angels to the lap of Abraham. The rich man also died and was buried. In hell and in torment, he looked up and saw Abraham in the distance and Lazarus in his lap. He called out, "Father Abraham, mercy, have mercy. Send Lazarus to dip his finger in water to cool my tongue. I'm in agony in this fire." That's the message. Fear filled the little girl's heart. If she ended up in hell, how would she cope? She would have no way of killing the worms, quenching the fire, or introducing light to get rid of the darkness. But what about the thirst? Wasn't there something she could do? After troubling her young mind for some time, she came up with a plan. She would start drinking plenty of water so that if she ended up in hell, it would take some time before she would begin to feel thirsty. And since she didn't know when Jesus would come, she had to keep drinking water, whether she was thirsty or not, so that at whatever point Jesus showed up and threw her into hell, she would have a lot of water reserved and wouldn't start feeling thirsty and miserable immediately. Many Christians are in the kind of situation in which little Brianna found herself, not quickly getting over what is wrong and therefore sorrowful because they believe they will definitely go to hell for eternity. However, if there is any sin that easily overwhelms and weighs you down, if there is any sin you fall into whenever you are tempted, no matter how much you try to resist it, do not let it push you into giving up on your hope of spending eternity in heaven. What we all need to do is cry out to Jesus to help us overcome. He said in Luke chapter 10 verse 19, "Listen, I have given you authority so that you can walk on snakes and scorpions and overcome all the power of the enemy, and nothing will hurt you." That's the Good News Translation. Ask Him to help you make use of the power He has given you to overcome every work of the devil, including the sin that has knocked you down many times. Then make conscious efforts also to see to it that you don't keep repeating the same sin. This may involve taking some practical steps to keep yourself from being exposed to the particular temptation that gets you all the time. For instance, if you know someone with whom you quarrel practically every time you meet, probably because that person is inconsiderate, a fault finder, or a disrespectful person who doesn't seem to want to change, do your best to avoid being around that person much, especially just the two of you alone. And if you are in a place with that person along with many others, keep a good distance from him or her and mingle with others. Where you must of a necessity be alone with that person, maybe you two have to work on a project together sitting in an office alone, for instance, just look up to Jesus for grace, wisdom, patience, and the love of God to deal with the fellow. But also keep praying for grace to overcome till you get to a point where you can be alone with that individual without sinning against God, no matter how annoying he or she gets. That's the ultimate, because you never know how many of such people God plans to bring into your life in future, because he wants to use you as a channel to reach out to them. If you don't learn now how to love and get along with them, you will end up failing God or forcing him to look for someone else to do the job he originally earmarked for you. If fornication or adultery is a sin you easily fall into, fill your heart with and constantly meditate on the word of God, and avoid getting into situations that could expose you to temptations, like spending time alone behind closed doors with your fiancé or, as a married person, a man or woman that's not your spouse. Let us get into the word, find out the will of God, and depend on his Spirit to help us obey it. We can and we will make it to heaven for eternity by the grace, mercy, and power of God. Don't write yourself off for any reason. Don't prepare your mind for an eternity in hell. Nothing can prepare anyone for what lies in hell. Have faith in God and prepare for heaven. May the Lord help us all in Jesus' name. Amen.